Hi students, welcome to another mini lectures in C programming. In this lecture, we are going to talk a little bit about data, because without data, there is no programming. The ultimate purpose of programming is to take in input raw data and convert it into meaningful information. So first, let's try to understand what is data. Data is simply raw facts. So, for example, your class roll number, your age, your address is all examples of data. Some of you may be surprised, even your photos is considered data. The songs you can record or the songs you sing is also data. So data can be numbers, it can be alphabets, it can be images, or it can be sound. The goal of a program is to take this input data and transform it into meaningful facts or meaningful information. For example, what may happen is I may take or I may read all the heights of all the students in my class. This is just raw data. Then if I try to find the average height of say 50 students, then it becomes meaningful information. So in our discussion here, we are going to be primarily focused on integers, characters, and real numbers, also called as floating point numbers. Let me tell you what is an integer. Now, if I have to ask your roll number, you will say it's either roll number 10, 15, 515, etc. You will never tell me a roll number is 515.26. So this is not an integer. So an integer is a number which doesn't have any fractional or decimal parts. It can be positive, it can be negative, or it can be zero, but it cannot be something like 2.2, 2.3, etc. Now let's understand what is real numbers or characters. Suppose you have to calculate the area of a circle. You will assume the value of pi to be 3.142. So here the value of pi is an example of a real or a floating point number, because it has after decimal places certain digits. So example of a integer could be this: 9 - 8, 1008 - 4995. Numbers without decimal place are known as integers. Now, C has certain interesting way of dealing with integers. Suppose you begin an integer number with 0, C treats it as that number as though it belongs to an octal number system. So this is not actually 34, this is 34 in octal system. It's not going to be exactly equal to 34 in decimal. Suppose you begin an integer number with 0x and then 56. 0x indicates that this integer happens to be a hexadecimal number or number to the base 16. Now, integers are useful in the sense, suppose you have a roll number, it makes much sense to store it as an integer than as a real number, because real numbers occupy more space as well as take more computer power to process. So where possible, use integers, and where it is unavoidable, then use real numbers or floating point numbers. Now, let's try to re-clarify what you mean by numbers with decimal places. Numbers with decimal places like this fellow, this fellow, this fellow, this fellow are called as floating point or real numbers. Okay, so you will use this in the case of like say pi. Suppose you have to calculate the salary. Salary could be 10,000 rupees 50 paise. These are examples of floating point or real numbers. Now, what are characters? Suppose I have to accept somebody's gender. So what I can say is gender is F or M. Okay, or it can be O for others. So these are known as character type of data. Characters consist of single character which are enclosed in a single quote. Do not enclose characters in a double quotes. They mean something totally different. Those are known as strings, which we will be discussing. So this hopefully should give you an idea about what exactly is data and what is its importance in programming. Our focus in C is going to be primarily on integers, real or floating point numbers, and character type of data.